ಶ್ರೀ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಶ್ರೀ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಶ್ರೀ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಶ್ರೀ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಗುರುರ್ಬ್ರಹ್ಮಾ ಗುರುರ್ವಿಷ್ಣು ಗುರುರ್ದೇವೋ ಮಹೇಶ್ವರಃ ಗುರು ಸಾಕ್ಷಾತ್ ಪರಂ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮ ತಸ್ಮೈ ಶ್ರೀ ಗುರವೇ ನಮಃ ತಸ್ಮೈ ಶ್ರೀ ಗುರವೇ ನಮಃ. Motivation comes from within. What we borrow is motivation, and what is from within is inspiration. Let me put this. Inspiration is an expression of your inner confidence and inner strength. Motivation is a force, burden on your head. So there are two aspects of our personality. One is our essential aspect. There are some people who are by default inspired. See, take our Prime Minister. He is not motivated in one of the schools I went, and children were told, you ask all the questions that you want to ask. Swamiji knows everything. So one child asked, Swamiji, what caption will you give? And showed me a picture. And the picture was, there was a bus stop, so many people, and near that bus stop sign, there was one lady, pretty fat. And challenge was given to me. What is the caption will you give? I said, bus stop, people waiting. No. I said, maybe the bus is late. They said, no. I said, okay, you tell me. Then that child told me, the caption is motivating. Motivating. That genius in that child was not taught to him. It comes from within. See, friends. And a person who is inspired, he has got one of the most important quality, and that quality is he has self-confidence. An inspired person doesn't lack self-confidence. Now the question is, where from the self-confidence come? Can we borrow it? Can we purchase it in the market? Can we inject it as a drug? Where from it comes? For that, we have to have the overall understanding about our life. Then we remain inspired. An inspired person is never tired. An inspired person is innovative. An inspired person is not a boredom. An inspired person is not a burden to others. An inspired person is an asset to the organization. An inspired person is in demand everywhere. If these things do not fit to us, we are not inspired. So those people who feel in an organization they are sidetracked and nobody bothers about them, I do so much hard but never I get recognition, the only reason is you are dumb. See, friends, therefore, let us take overall picture. First picture. Whatever position you are holding, whether you are in the top or in between various layers of your organizational hierarchy, doesn't matter. Every one of us is an ideal for someone or the other. Everyone. To understand this principle, I'll tell you an example. I was somewhere in Bombay because of traffic jam. I feel many times we should change the name of Mumbai into Jamnagar. I don't know how they have this Jamnagar in Gujarat, where the traffic is not at all. How they call it Jamnagar, God knows. So I was just sitting in the car, and roadside there was one child sitting on a auto rickshaw parked and imagining that he is driving, like he was doing. So I had to somehow pass time. So I asked him, "Hey, what are you doing?" He said, "I am driving this rickshaw. You want to come somewhere?" I said, "I'll come later. Now you tell me, what you want to become when you become big?" Me? He was so inspired. He has already plans in his mind. He has no doubt. He has confidence. And he was ready to jump into it. He said, "I want to become an auto rickshaw driver like my father. I will also drive like this." For you and me, auto rickshaw driver is just one ordinary person. But for the child, the father is an ideal. So what is the bottom of the story? Every one of us is an ideal for someone or the other. Don't condemn yourself. "Hum to mama aise hi hai." No. See, you are an ideal for someone or the other. And to be an ideal is a responsibility. It is not an asset, it is a liability. See, friends, to be on the top and not to be a source of motivation for the subordinates is the highest crime that we can conduct in this world. See, friends. And how this is, you all must have seen in your houses. I think most of you are married. Some of you may be happy also. This definition I learned in England. I was having a retreat. After the retreat was over, one person, a Britisher, asked me this question. He said, "Mr. Swami, you are married?" I said, "No." "Come on. Happiness is not everything in life." That day I discovered there are two types of people in this world. Those who are married and those who are happy. So you have got both the types of people here. So you must have seen in your house, brother and sister, small, maybe 5-7 years. During summer time, they have lot of time. So they play among themselves. So the brother becomes the husband, the sister becomes the wife. And they play home. And in that game that they play home, there is no script writer. There is no choreographer. There is no director. Because every day they are seeing at home what is happening. And everything is by-hearted by them. So they start playing. So the brother says to his sister, "Shall we start our home? "Yes, yes, we'll start." So he comes from outside, just in the same room where there is no stage. They are only imagining. And he comes and knocks at the door. Tack, 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 tack. There is nothing there, but they are playing. And then the sister wife opens the door. And their door must be making a noise. So, ra-ra-ra-ra-ra, she makes the noise. The door opened. And then he enters. The moment he enters, he asks his wife, "Do you have something to eat?" Because every day the father must be saying this. And then she replies, the same reply must be every day. That moment you come at home, you want to eat, 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 eat my head. So the father gives the reply, "That is why I am starving, it is empty." And then he takes out from his pocket something called a cigarette, puts in his mouth, Now, who taught him? Yad yad acharati shreshtaha tatnadeve taro janaha sa yad pramanam kurute lokas tadanu vartate. Those people who complain about their subordinates, they don't deserve to be at the higher level. Friends, subordinates need motivation. And motivation can be given only by the one who is inspired. If we are dumb type, somehow get in. See, one day I was in a gathering like this. There was one sweet girl sitting right in front. So after that she came to do namaskar. So I asked her, I said, hey, I want to ask you one question. This is my general knowledge. Said, you are a stenographer, is it not? She said, how do you know? I said, don't worry about it. You are? She said, yes. I said, you must be having a nice time, is it? Don't have to think about anything. Whatever the boss tells, dictate it, type it and take it. That's it. Finish it off. He said, no, Swamiji. I said, what problem you can have? You have no responsibility. He said, that is not the only thing. Then she told her story. He said, my boss, when he comes in the office, the first thing he does by default, presses the bell, so I have to go. And I already opened the mail and kept in front of me. He said, okay, take dictation. And he tells, this is letter number, this is the reference, write down. We are thankful to you for your valuable orders and we shall see that it is executed in due time. Thank you very much for selecting us. And I take that dictation and go to my room. And those days, no laptops. So I put it in the typewriter. And I'm just going to sit and start. Again the bell rings. Again I had to go back. That later, you get it back? Yes. Cancel that. Then, now write down again. Same reference. We are thankful to you. However, because of constant electricity problem and the labor problem, we will not be able to execute as you want, but we will execute as per our convenience. You have to deposit 90% advance and then suffer silently. And so she said, I again go back and I put the paper and I just start, tuck, 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 again the bell rings. And again I go, listen, cancel that. Then tomorrow I am anyway going on leave. Why worry? Let the other person take decision. Be attentive. She said, to work with such a dumb, uninspired person is the terrible misfortune for me. See, friends, everybody wants to be with an active, dynamic person. Therefore, simply remaining at the top is not an asset, it is a big liability. And the liability is if we are able to motivate, inspire people below our ranks, then we are successful bosses. Simply condemning somebody is the easiest job. The reality is, we are able to bring out the best in our subordinates. Then we are genius. Because depends on which side of the table you are sitting. See? You must have gone through where you are giving interview or conducting interview. There are two sides of the table. When you are on the side of conducting the interview as the expert panel and the candidate comes and sits there, that time the modes are different. Whatever you say has to be right. And if the change happens, then everything changes. Because which side of the table you are, that determines what you are. See, friends, to condemn somebody that he is good for nothing, he is not the genius of a top person. See, friends, this principle I learned yesterday, I told it to some place. In Bombay, people live in match boxes, very small houses, 1 BHK, half BHK, 1.5 BHK. So I came from somewhere, a long journey, and landed in their house, and I had to go to bathroom, very high BP. BP means bladder pressure. So I went straight away and knocked, "Hey, come on, who is inside?" Their daughter was inside. She said, "Swamiji, just 1 minute, please." And then she gave me instruction from inside. "Swamiji, there is a sticker on our door, toilet door. Read that meanwhile." And she said, "I'm just coming in 1 minute." And the sticker reads, "How long is 1 minute depends on which side of the door you are." Who is capable and who is not capable depends on which side of the table you are. See, friends, condemning somebody is not the way to motivate the people. See, friends, we have to be inspired. An inspired person doesn't teach through words. An inspired person demonstrates through action. One example I'll tell you. There was one person, Mr. Agrawal. He is no more now. This is a very old story, 40 years before. This happened in Guwahati, in Assam. He was an elderly man. That time he was about 70, 75. So he was honored by many people, about 200, and all good top industrialists of that northeast region up to Calcutta, with all the necktie, this thing and everything, standard CEO uniform. And this person, Mr. Agrawal, he was with dhoti, kurta, and one gamcha, and I was invited to honor him. So when I looked at him, I said, "You know, what honor, and these people, I couldn't make it, what it could be?" And I was surprised. Everybody who was coming in, he was touching his feet and sitting in the place. And thereafter, they started talking, one each person, few minutes, 10 minutes here and there. And everybody told one common thing: what I am today is exclusively because of Babuji. He was called a Babuji, because of Babuji. And what he has done, only one thing: he was a pillar to motivate anybody who comes around him. And he never caught hold of somebody. He brought out the best in that person and let him go. And those people independently grew to a big, big way. And when all these people from different industry, somebody from steel industry, somebody from tea industry, somebody from making the spare parts, somebody was a pharmaceutical, all variety of things. Not one or two, but about 200 of them in a big hall like this. And this simple man with a dhoti and this thing, and sitting comfortably. So after everything was over, then I asked, "Babaji, you are great, I never knew. Please tell me, what is the secret?" He said, "I am uneducated, I don't know anything, but I know one thing, that if you have a human touch, you can change anything and anybody in this world." Friends, management has three factors. Like in the earlier days, they used to say, if you have to destroy, the three W's destroy, isn't it? Wealth, wine, and woman. WWW. Today, the www.com, that destroys. And what is management? You make the Shirshasana of WWW. It becomes MMM. So what is management? Management is man, material, and methodology. Material is stable in its behavior. Material doesn't change. If it is steel, it will have the same way behavior. It will not change time to time. If it is clay, it will have the same way. If it is cement, it will have the same way. So material doesn't involve too much of problem in solving the management crisis. Methodology can be standardized according to the need. That also is not a big problem. The real problem comes when the element man comes into management. And managing a man requires some extra feature. And the extra feature is that person must be an ideal in whose presence everybody gets motivated. Not under fear, but under reverence. And this can be achieved. I'll tell you one more example. This happened in Delhi. There is to be a person in Government of India's office, a very big post. He was the town planner. And everything to be done in Delhi must go through him. So there is to be about a dozen architects working with him. And he was the chief boss. And he was about 60 years of age, and his wife was pretty young, maybe about 45 or so. And unfortunately, she died of cancer. So this person went into depression. He was teaching in college also. So one of his students told him, "Sir, we know what has happened. So why don't you come to our Swamiji's talks?" He said, "What Swamiji? I have never gone to any temple, any Swami, I don't believe." He said, "You don't have to believe, you just come for a time pass. Some change will happen. So when you are frustrated, you are ready to try anything. From allopathy to naturopathy to homeopathy." So he came, and then he became a very close friend. For 2 years he was every day driving me for the lecture, bringing me back home every day. And after I left, then he said, "Swamiji, what will I do?" I said, "Now you do what you like. I have nothing to do with you." Again, after about a year or so, I happened to visit Delhi. I met him. I said, "Hey, Moshai, how are the things?" He was a Bengali. "How are the things?" He said, "Swamiji, I have learned one thing from you." I said, "What is that? Tell me." And he said, "That principle I have applied in my life. Most of the problems are solved." I said, "Tell me also, let me know." He told, "Whenever there is to be any project, every project meeting used to end up in a war. There used to be argument, logic, like that. I used to get excited, frustrated, my subordinates very, very angry. And finally, okay, sir, we'll do what you want. And there is, this. And when I used to go home, my wife used to be there to support me, and we used to have tea, coffee, but now she is not there, and I was suffering, both in the office and at home. But now, one day you told one technique. The technique is," he only told me, I don't remember what I told, because I bluff and I forget. He said, "What I did, I kept the plan on the table. And there are about more than a dozen architects, different branches. I said, 'Hey, this is the plan, and each one of you put your views.' He said, that day I had decided I am not going to talk or participate at all, holding myself inside. Swamiji, 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 I was doing the japa." Very good. First person said, second said, all of them presented their views. I was just watching. And thereafter, I told them, "Very good, you already discussed, you know what you all have discussed. Now, what will you conclude from your own discussions? Let me know." Again, I kept quiet. They were discussing. I was having a cup of tea. After that, they came to a conclusion. And the conclusion was exactly the same. what I would have come to the conclusion. But now the difference was, earlier it was my decision, they have to execute. Now it is their decision, they have to honor. See the difference? Friends, we can motivate others if the people working in our team feel this is our project. It is not a project imposed on us by the top boss. That is the secret of activation of motivation through an inspired person. Normally what happens is this only. I tell you, do this, this, this. Mm-hmm. They will do it, but there won't be life in that. They'll be simply, okay, 10 to 5 and go home. No. So the real inspiration is we motivate our people to participate and be a part of the total project. Then you will see, then they will never think of going here and there. See, friends, therefore, inspiration is working on the material called as human beings. And you can't have the same treatment for everybody. And it is here the genius of the top person comes. Top means every one of us. Don't forget that. Every one of us is an ideal for someone or the other. You can't forget about it. So in this manner, when we are able to recognize the potentiality of a person working under us. See, I'll tell you one small example. There is one girl. She is unable to talk properly because she is not much educated. But as regards her sincerity, commitment and doing the job is concerned, she is superb. See? Only thing what she lacks is communication because she is not highly educated. A school in a local medium she studied. So I always honor her, I love her, and she does the job. The one person told me, Swamiji, you have got so much of things, why don't you get someone educated to do the job? I said, look here, I don't want to go into the credentials given by the university. I am observing the performance of the person. See, friends, we don't get carried away by the stamp of the universities. He is a become an MBA and all that. MBAs are good for nothing. They are working only on theoretical basis. See, friends, a genius is never holding a degree. One example I'll give you. There is one boy. He is a graduate of commerce. He has never studied computers, but he has interest in that. And he was in Ranchi many years before. And just to earn bread, he started a computer institution. And for that he learned also, because he is a genius. And little bit learning, and he was giving training to the students and all that. All of them, they will say, after this is over, we'll pay, now we don't have money. And he was a simpleton boy. So the students will come, learn and go, never pay him. And net result was, he has to close down the institution. Everything gone. Once it so happened, in SAIL, the Steel Authority of India Limited, they had invited one software person to install one software for their plant. He came from USA, spending thousands and hundreds of dollars, and tried to fix the software. He could not do it for 1 week. Now they say, hey, let us call our local Subbu, he will do something. His name is Subbu. So a young boy, maybe hardly that time 22, 23, he was caught. See, what can you do? He said, if you all go out, I will do it. I don't want you anybody around me. And he sat there for almost 8-10 hours. And that software, which that expert could not fit in, he sorted it out and started. When I was told about him, Swamiji, he is such and such, I said, hey, you come with me. I took him to Germany. And he joined some company. After 4 or 5 years, that company was closed. He says, Swamiji, what next? I said, now go to US. So he came to US. He is not software engineer at all. Today, he is heading one of the top software industry institution and doing so well. He is one among very few in USA. And basic qualification, he doesn't have engineering degree. A genius is a genius. Don't get carried away by the so-called stamps. Recognize the genius of a people from the output. It's not somebody is very goody-goody. Another point I'll tell you, you may not like it. These goody-goody characters are dangerous. All the time, sir, sir, yes, sir, yes, sir. I come on time, I go on time. In between, I do nothing. It doesn't matter how many hours you work. What matters is how much you work within a limited time. That is important. See, in this manner, when the top person is able to motivate, is able to discover the hidden potentiality in their subordinates, then he is successful. And success is most important point. Let every person in the organization feel, this is my organization. That is the success. Nobody should feel, anyway, till I get some other job, like in one place I went in Kuala Lumpur, there were two temples. One was a North Indian type of temple, too much of lights and too much of marble and too much of mirrors and all that, you know, like a Bollywood type of temple. And all the Bhagwans there, you know, they were standing, you know, like a military drill all around. So when I went there, the moment you enter the temple, you don't feel the presence of the divine because there is no proper puja, etc. done. So when I went there, I did a common namaskar to all of them. And then went to take tirth and prasad from the Panditji. What the Panditji told me? Swamiji, you are going to Australia from here. Do you know somebody who can sponsor me so that I can go to Australia? You can imagine. A Pandit who is sitting in front of the God, instead of having devotion to the God, this is his mind. How can you invoke divinity in that statue? In the same manner, we are working in some organization, but all the time our mind is, if I get a chance, I'll get out from here. Then it is a total failure on the part of the management. See, friends, it is most important that we are able to take care of their needs and able to keep them motivated. And this can happen only when they become as one team, more of we, less of I. But most of the places, this is what happens. I told you to do this, I am telling you, you have to do this thing. And thus the participation is withdrawn. One example I'll tell you in your family life. One day, one husband was telling me, Swamiji, I don't know what to do with my wife. I said, no husband knows. No, no, not like that. She is constantly doubting me. My profession is such that I had to talk on phone. I had to contact many people. And she thinks, you know, I am talking with the girls. So what should I do? I said, look here. First of all, try to understand. Don't misunderstand her. Any family where relation is a matter of fact, that is not a family. It is a hospital. She is all the time doubting because she loves you. But what kind of love it is? I said, it is a very abnormal type of love. But it is love. The day she will say, okay, you go your way, I go my way. Then understand, then the bond of love between the two is dried up. See, friends, in the same manner, when we are dealing with the people, if we try to understand them, why they are feeling like this, so it is our responsibility to take them in confidence and help them to come out of the wrong notions. With this alone, we are remain inspired and we remain a source of motivation to our subordinates and people around us. See, friends. And this inspiration can be nurtured. We have to have it. Nobody can give us inspiration from outside. Be very clear about it. From outside, what we get is motivation. It is not inspiration. Like you must have seen in music, the taal, the rhythm in the music cannot be taught. You have to have it in you. Next time you go to some function where the music is, and you will see there are some Aurangzebs who are unable to have the perfect taal, but they want to give the taal. So they will be given exactly at the wrong time. And you try, you cannot do it. Because they don't have it in them. It cannot be taught in the same manner. Inspiration cannot be taught. You see, all the great masters in the world, they were inspired. And then they were able to motivate the masses. See, take for example, our Mahatma Gandhi. In Pietermaritzburg, where he was thrown out of the railway compartment, I go there every year for talk. On the railway station where he was thrown, there is a plate fixed there. It is here Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi was asked to get out by the whites after the apartheid. They had done all that. So, he was not told by anybody what to do, but he was inspired from within. And therefore, he was able to motivate so many millions. See. Therefore, inspiration comes from within, number one. Now, does it mean we are a gone case? No. If we get motivated, then if we maintain the motivation for a longer period of time, it gets metamorphosed into inspiration. Then how to do this? Is it possible or is it just a theory or imagination? We all have two principles common. One is the energy as action and dynamism. Secondly, the energy as knowledge and wisdom. Two of them. Now to understand this, take an example. Suppose you draw two lines from one point. Can these two lines be parallel to each other? They cannot be parallel. For example, from my palm, why I show it like this is because once it so happened, in a nice group we were sitting and I was explaining something. When I did my hand like this thing, one person sitting in the front, he was looking so cautiously at my palm. I said, hey, what are you looking? Swamiji, I am seeing your lines. Say, my God, you are here to listen our lines. From that time onward, I show like this. So, these two fingers, they come from a common point, the palm. These two fingers next to each other cannot be parallel. So be attentive. It's a very simple example. As the distance from the source goes on increasing, the gap between the two starts widening. Is it not? Very simple. One is the potentiality of knowledge and wisdom. Second is the potentiality of action and dynamism. Both of them are coming out of from the same source. We have both knowledge and dynamism. Now, next step. If our knowledge is not represented in our action. Means what? The gap between the two is increasing. If the gap between the two is increasing, we are going away from the source. Get this point. It's very simple. And the net result is lack of self-confidence. Now, to understand this principle, take some example. We all know, in our childhood also we have studied in the school, KG1, KG2. Early to bed and early to rise is the way to be healthy, wealthy and wise. Everybody knows. What is our life? Late to bed and late to rise is the way to be unhealthy and otherwise. Who doesn't know this? Every one of us. But then we keep on waking late at night. 12 o'clock. And what we do that time? All rubbish. Nothing productive, nothing creative. See, friends. Then as a result, we are completely exhausted, tired. And next day when we get up, there is a hang-up. See, friend, how we begin our day determines how we live our day. If you begin your day in an inspired mode, you will be successful in whatever you do. But if you begin our day, oh God, come on, get up, go on. There was a mother, she was telling her son, beta, get up, you have to go to school. No, mommy, no, no, no. Again he slept. Again poor old mother came and again waking up. Come on, go to school. No, mommy. Finally, the mother got angry. Now it is 8:30. You have to leave at 9 o'clock. You have to go to school. Please wake up. So the son got angry. Why should I go to school? The mother said, because you are a principal of the school. Without that, the school will not start. Now tell me, such a principal, what will be the quality of that school, children? In the same manner, we the top people in every department, if we are not inspired, what will the others know from us? Be very attentive. We all take care of everything so much meticulously. What should be the type of house? Which should be the locality? What type of furniture should be? It should be matching with the walls. The drapery should be perfect. The crockery should be beautiful. The clothing should be matching. See, red nail polish, red lower thing, red upper thing, red.com, red purse matching. How much care we take? Food, how much care? I eat only organic food, as if there is inorganic food. Food is always organic. And then we are worried about our figure. It's good. But what care we take about our mind, by which we conduct the whole business of life? See, friends, those who want to maintain the figure of their body, they calculate the calories, they calculate the cholesterol and do the exercise, then the figure is maintained. It doesn't come from heaven. In the same manner, what care we have taken about our mind? The food for the mind is the thoughts that we give. Before going to sleep, if you see all horrible movies, terrible movies, you know. Chalti gaadi mein latakti laash. And whole, they're all crime and all dirty things. And with that, you go to sleep. And you see, your wife is latki. But when you wake up, oh God, I thought you are gone. Friends, what kind of food we give to our mind that determines the quality of our thoughts. As is the quality of our thoughts, so is the quality of our life. See, therefore, these two potentialities that we have, the knowledge and action. See, you must have seen throughout the world, the children that they play, what is the play that they are playing? Whether they are digital games or anywhere, only taking the, you know, gun in the hand. Only one game throughout the world, anywhere you go. Because that is what all, everywhere is available, nothing else. Therefore, friends, if we take care of this simple thing, that if you have to start your day early morning, you will have to sleep early. If you have to sleep early, you will have to cut down all unwanted involvement in this world. And then you begin your day in an inspired mode. Anything you do with inspiration, success is guaranteed. See, friends, like these people who run for the race, 100 meter race, 1000 meter race, they are standing there in a pose, waiting for the signal to go. And when the signal goes, they don't run, they shoot like a bullet. But if a person like me standing there with a lungi and the kada, and the signal goes, yaar ruki, yaar main theek kar leta hu. No. In the same manner, an inspired person begins his day early in the morning. Friends, give it a try. Only for 1 week. I'm not asking you much. Give it a try. Go to sleep early. Even if he doesn't come, doesn't matter. Lie down on the bed. I'll tell you one technique. Don't do it now or in the office. This technique is very simple. Come on. Many people have got this problem. They can't sleep. Therefore, they keep on watching TV, do the laptop and all that. That is destroying yourself. Try this technique. If you don't get sleep, the only reason is you are unable to drop the unwanted garbage from your head. So you come on the left side of your body, lie down, and keep the pillow to the height of your shoulder on the left side, so that there is no kink in your trachea. Thereafter, close your eyes. According to our Upanishad, it is said that in deep sleep, we live in our heart. In dream, we live in our throat. In the waking experience, we live in our right eye. These are the three places where we live. So in the deep sleep, if we are living in our heart, so now you start playing sleep. So you lie down, and then how do you play sleep? What is the sleep? In sleep, you breathe deep and slow. So lie down and start playing. I guarantee you, in no time you will sleep. And be attentive. The first sleep that you have, 2 hours, 3 hours, that is your real sleep. The second dose of sleep that you get, it will be not a perfect sleep. And in that period, if you again happen to get up, leave the bed. And after that, if you have nothing to do, do some exercise. Go for a walk, read something, write something, take cold water bath. But leave the bed immediately. Don't hang on the bed. You watch yourself. When we get up in the morning, getting out of the sleep is never a problem. Getting out of the bed is the biggest problem. See, that is why Vivekananda and Kathopanishad tells, Uttishtata jagrata prapya varan nimodhata kshurasya dhara nishita durateya durgam patastat kavayo vadanti. First of all, get up and then wake up. Because waking up is not a problem. So, our sleep is over, be attentive. It's a very subtle point, don't just take it lightly. So, sleep is over, but we don't get out of the bed, do you think the mind will remain quiet? The mind will start unnecessarily thinking all unwanted things. Like before we go to sleep, we put our phone for charging. So whole night the phone is charged. It can be used for the day. In the same manner, we charge ourselves when we go to deep sleep. In the morning when we get up but don't come out of the bed, then what happens? All the charge is discharged. 1 hour, 1.5 hour, 2 hours. So we sleep on the back starts paining, we come to the left side starts paining, right starts paining, then we come on the stomach, bhujangasana, that also starts paining, the pressure develops, then by nature's force we get up. Is it a human life? Is it like being a pig? Friends, those who cannot leave the bed early in the morning before sunrise, in the next life they become bed bugs. So next time you see a bed bug, don't kill it. Agla aisa hi hai apna. Give it a try. You will see, you will have a totally different lifestyle from that day onwards. And then you will be always inspired to do things. See, friends. And as a result, what will happen? Now, the second important point. If we respect our knowledge in action, the gap between the two starts reducing. Thereafter, what we decide, that happens. We have no doubt, because now the self-confidence is gained. Any person who is inspired, he doesn't have doubt. Inspired person doesn't think like this, you know, I think I should get it, you know, but let us try. No, he goes with the confidence, I am going to do it and I will win it. It comes only if we are integrated inside. We have to remain integrated. And integration is nothing great other than respect your knowledge in your life. Our knowledge is, things should be done the same day. Never keep anything postponed for the next day. How simple it is. Finish it. Those who cannot finish the work during the office hours and carry the burden at home, they are not fit for that job. Finish your office work in office completely. When you go home, become a husband, become a father, become a mother, and enjoy your life. This I learned from one family I went. I was playing with the children, and the father's car came. The children, Swamiji, Hitler has come. Say, what happened? He said, no, I will talk to you later. Immediately they packed up everything, they went to their room and all quiet. And then the father came and he asked, Swamiji, did the children trouble you? I wanted to say, but I was also afraid. I said, no, you are troubling me. I was enjoying with them. Then he said, my children are extremely disciplined. They know I don't like it. I become angry with them. They know my anger. Friends, is it a good quality of a father? When the father goes home, children go back into the holes like the rats? On the contrary, who is the real successful father? When the father comes home, children leave everything as if an Alsatian jump out of their skin and hug the dad. That is the real fulfillment in life. But why this happens? Because this filaria, carrying the files from the office to the home and home to the office. Such people are not sincere in both the places. When they are in the office, they think about the gas connection. And when they are at home, they are working on the files. Both the places, they are successfully unsuccessful. See, friends. Therefore, an inspired person is aware of all this. Therefore, when you are taking food, enjoy. When you are doing your job, do perfectly well. When you are relaxing, relax. That is all necessary in life. See, friends, and the whole thing can be put together only by one word. If you are inspired, all these qualities will be inherent in you. Don't have to do anything special for that. Then we remain aware of the time, where we have to go, we reach there on time. When we have to finish the job is done during that time. And such a person is never short of time. Those who are short of time, they are not fit for the job. Time is infinite, or potentiality is infinite. Bring these two infinities together, you are inspired. Then alone, our words carry meaning. You must have seen sometimes people are, when they are not able to handle it, they become angry. In Sanskrit it is said, Shesham Kopena Purayen. When you cannot handle, become angry and quieten the other person. But how long are we going to cheat? The real ability of a person is this. Let everybody working with us have this experience or feeling that this is our institution. This is our organization. This is what our Prime Minister has been successful to some extent. The people started feeling, being respectful of being Indian. I move around the world, whether it is China or it is New Zealand or it is South Africa or South America. Everywhere, all the Indians that I come across, so many of them, they say clearly, we have started having a sense of respect given to us by the people. That is the success of a leader. The same thing is true in any organization. So, if we look at him, he becomes an inspired model for us. If we simply copy what his lifestyle is, you will see sincerity, dedication, no selfish motives, being firm, disciplined, committed. All these qualities, they are put together, makes an inspired person. And such a person alone can be a creative leader. Otherwise, you know, all the time lost only, yeah, how much will I get? How much will I get? Other than frustration, you will get nothing thereafter. Therefore, friends, inspiration is first, if we don't have, borrow it from the inspired people, get motivated. And then maintain that motivation by this technique. Respect your knowledge in your action. Knowledge is, anger is not good. So do not be a victim of the anger. Knowledge is, we should be disciplined as regard time is concerned. We should be there on right time. Whether others come or not is not our business. We should be disciplined. In this manner, slowly we bring out the hidden potentiality in every one of us. And then alone, the life becomes meaningful. Therefore, only the external work is not enough. The internal poise is equally important. So, we will be able to play every role. Officer's role in the office, husband's roles at the home. The subordinate's role in the office and the father's role with the children. Every role we will be able to perform perfectly well. That perfection in performance in every department of our role that we have to play is inspiration in action. We all can do it. There is no exception. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti 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 Harihi Om Sri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om.